Påsken står för dörren med Kopparbergs Göteborg FCs ytterbackar Natalia Koika och Emma Koivisto är på jakt efter lite finska specialiteter. Mängden Sverige-finländare i Göteborg garanterar ett visst utbud av makkara, sinappi och karelska piroger. Under 1960- och 70-talets arbetskraftsinvandring bidrog en stor mängd finländska arbetare till den svenska textil- och verkstadsindustrin. Inte minst varven i Göteborgs hamninlopp blev en stor arbetsgivare. Drygt 50 år senare är Koika och Koivisto via en omväg till USA och college-spel på Florida State här för att förstärka upp Kopparbergs backlinje. Koivisto var först ut när hon inför förra säsongen rekommenderades av en annan för detta finsk spelare i Kopparberg.
After being in the US, I was feeling a little homesick, so I wanted to go to a country close to home. And Adelina Engman had told about me to the coaches, and then they contacted me if I wanted to come here. And then I really liked it here, and the culture is more like in Finland. So I liked being here and playing here.
Till årets säsong anslöt så Natalia Koika.
I came here to visit so I could see a little bit of the city and meet the coaches and the staff before I even, you know, signed the papers. Markus and Jörgen were really nice and they seemed that they know a lot about soccer, so it was a, you know, comfortable choice for me to come here. And now meeting the players and training with them and playing games, they're all really talented and I enjoy playing with the talented players.
Som spelare på Florida State University fick de med 4 års mellanrum vara med om att vinna det största man kan vinna inom den amerikanska collegeidrotten, NCAA.
I won it my freshman year, so I didn't realize then how big it was. So then I think, like after being there for 4 seasons, I realized how big it actually was. Because after the first year, I thought that it would be something that we will win every year. And I didn't realize how big it was, but now I think it's huge.
Yeah, I won my senior year, so my last year, my freshman year. We made it to the final games, but we didn't win. And after that, we didn't do that well, that it was expected of us. But it was great to win my last year, and it was a big thing. You don't realize it until, you know, it's behind. Then you realize that it was a big thing, and not a lot of players win that title.
Och Koivisto och Koika, som vid sidan av fotbollen studerade ekonomi respektive kriminologi, rekommenderar college-livet.
I think it was a really good way to combine studying and playing football. And I think I grew as a person a lot in there, and the football, or the level of football, is really good in there, and I think it's a good step before going to play as a professional.
Förutom spel i Kopparbergs Göteborg är Koika och Koivisto även bofasta i Finlands landslag. Ett Finland som är under utveckling.
I think the level of the league in Finland is lower than here. I think here you have better players and who come from different countries to play just here. So the tempo and the players' individual level of skill is better than in Finland. But I think now that our Finnish national team is getting more support from our federation, we're getting, you know, better at the soccer we're doing, and we're all having like the same ideas of where we want to go and what goals we want to reach. And I think, yeah, we're maybe still a little bit behind, but I think we're taking big steps to, you know, reach the gap.
When will we see Finland in World Cup?
I don't know. Hopefully soon as possible. Yeah. I think we have a really good team, so I think we have really good chances to make it to World Cup.
Men just nu är det stora målet att bidra till Kopparbergs framgångar. I lagets andra damallsvenska match för säsongen mot Eskilstuna på Valhalla IP inför närmare 1000 åskådare gör de löpstarka fysiska tvåvägsspelarna som vanligt en stark insats på sina respektive kanter. Hemmalaget har ett kompakt spelövertag. Men det är först efter paus som Taylor Leach från nära håll forcerar in ledningsmålet efter en frispark av Elin Rudensson. Leach blir dessvärre inte matchhjälte. Med kvarten kvar kvitterar Eskilstuna och fastställer slutresultatet till 1-1. Just det. Så var det ju det där med sten, sax och påse.
It's our handshake. So in United States I had handshakes with some of my teammates and I wanted to bring that into this team and with Emma. She really didn't want to do it, so I tried to make it easy for her. So rock paper scissors I thought was a fun and easy way to, you know, give us like a little boost before the game and, you know, cheer us up.
Yeah, at first I was like, there's no way I'm doing those silly handshakes that Natu always did in the US. But then we tried it in the first cup game against Jitex. And then I did a hat-trick in that game. It was my first hat-trick in like my whole life. So then we had to continue doing that.
Okay, cool. Rock, paper, scissors, and then.
Okay.